Well, good day, this is Neo Scyther getting back to my WWE 2K16 career series, yes. And that was me trying to put on a very, very bad British accent type thing, I don't know. Anyways, it's December week 3, 2020. I'm losing my mind at this point. Partially because I just tried to talk all fancy and British. And partially because this game's actually giving me a rivalry. Its own rivalry. And for the second time in a row, I'll be defending my championship at a pay-per-view. And since it's TLC, it might be a gimmick match. I haven't had one of those in a while. But of course, now Lesnar wants a rematch from SmackDown. The authority goal is performing the F5. Okay, so that, let's go ahead and get on with Monday Night Raw.
Oftentimes in our business, the only way for personal issues to be ultimately resolved is two superstars enter the squared circle and go one-on-one in a good old-fashioned wrestling match. Today, too fast. He's got him hooked.
I can actually pull a move off that, him slapping my arm.
What are your thoughts on this legendary athlete?
You're talking about someone who has all the talent necessary to become one of the all-time greats.
Oh, out of nowhere!
Yes, a clothesline out of nowhere. Thank you, King.
Oh, wait, nice reversal.
The repetition on that move is becoming deliberate at this point.
To stop. People do it all the time in the match.
Quick thinking to avoid that.
When his strikes land, you can feel it in the first few rows.
Uh-oh. A ferocious clothesline. Just devastating.
Well, when the signature moves of Brock Lesnar become the topic, it's unavoidable that talk will turn to the powerbomb. The beast is rattled.
Okay, game, don't start randomly just topping on me.
Who's climbed into that ring with him using that maneuver?
Three. Here we go. And he brings the action back inside the ring.
Yeah, I think this is good strategy.
Yeah, kind of got to be on the inside of the ring to win.
Looking to be in great shape here. It doesn't appear as though any damage has been done.
Ooh, smart. Okay, he backed up.
One.
Whee!
That just crushed him.
We need to be sure that whenever we do talk about Brock Lesnar's powerbomb, we talk about it in the plural, because the man never stops with just one. Once he's got someone set up,
like a potato chip,
he's going to execute it on them again.
The Brock Lesnar powerbomb is like a potato chip. You can't just have one.
What an incredible power bomb! Well, out here you have to be able to think.
Yeah, let's talk about my power bombs.
One mistake, one moment of hesitation.
At least when I do them, they send you outside the ring. Which is kind of bad, because it means I can't really do them to you when you're inside the ring. But
my God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
Man, I hope we can get a doctor out here as a precaution. Damaged ribs like that can make it hard to breathe.
What I want to know is where Brock Lesnar finds the strength to perform all those multiple power bombs. It's hard enough to attempt one, but he'll pull off three in a row like it's nothing.
Well, have a look at the man, Michael. I mean, that is the beast incarnate. Brock Lesnar lifts WWE superstars like you lift groceries.
Sure.
Going for the cover.
The offense of Brock Lesnar is working well right now.
Yeah, because I can't really do much.
My God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
Man, I hope we can get a doctor out here as a precaution. Damaged ribs like that can make it hard to breathe.
He goes for the quick pin attempt. Count, ref, count.
Quick pin attempt. It's been a while here during the match. It's one of the things we consider a quick pin attempt anymore.
Oh, out of nowhere. What a reversal.
Few superstars are as dominant as this guy.
Not today. Too fast.
Going for it again.
Oh, once you get out of the ring, anything can happen. You've got exposed steel, concrete, the barricades, and all of it can be used to cause massive damage.
He's making a statement here with this attack.
Yeah, I knocked over the ref. That is my statement.
He's not exactly popping up to his feet here.
Well, what do you expect, Michael? Did you see what just happened?
In the pantheon of finishers, Brock Lesnar's F5 has got to rank right near the top, does it not?
Oh, without a doubt.
The list of victims that the Beast is subjected to that move is like a who's who of WWE greats. No one is immune to it. Delivering the damage to the chest now.
Well,
that's his back, Cole.
Boy, he just got laid out.
People have been wanting to see these guys go at it for a long time, and by the sound of this crowd, I think they're getting what they wanted. Looking to build momentum.
Hey, the shoulders are down.
One, two.
Of all the names on that list of Brock Lesnar's F5 victims, the one that stands out
they
the most
to, go
to
up
me
top.
Is Big Show. I mean, we're talking about a 7-foot tall.
There, now take a shot to the head, please. Thank you.
Close the books. This thing's over.
He is slowly getting dissected.
They say imitation's the sincerest form of flattery, but I don't think that's the case here.
I don't think so either, Cole.
No, I think so.
Oh, nice counter.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me. He reversed it.
I know they call him the Beast, but that was just beautiful.
Are you kidding me? Into an F5.
The F5 Brock Lesnar performed on the Big Show at the Royal Rumble was a spectacle, the likes of which we've rarely ever seen. But, King, earlier you alluded to the other legends the Beast has used the F5 on.
Oh, you mean like Kurt Angle at WrestleMania 19? Or that John Cena fella? Well, how about The Rock? And
wow, King, I didn't think we would see this. Talk about defying the odds. The roof's gonna blow off this place.
When this guy's on, look out.
Hey, he's going for it again.
Again, it's the first time I've gone for a Blue Thunder Bomb.
Oh, man. How do you stand after an attack like this?
He's obviously making fun of his opponent here.
The nerve of this guy.
Come on. Get up.
We've seen this before.
Just not from me.
He's adding insult to injury by using that move against his opponent.
Oh, man. This may not end well.
Welcome to my... Oh, you got to be kidding. I was going to say welcome to my mind games, but,
You can't say enough about the athletic skills of Brock Lesnar. Look at him go to work.
Ah! Here we go. Powerbomb City.
Brock Lesnar delivering crippling punishment.
We now have to question if he'll be able to come back after that.
He's got the shoulders down, Cole.
This could be it.
And a kick out. Not even after one from Powerbomb City.
Great one-on-one action here tonight. It doesn't get much better than this.
Uh-oh. Climbing the top.
Remember how I beat you the last time? Let's see if I can do it again.
Incoming.
Why do I even... try. Do I not know by now that you can catch someone into an F5? You know, because he did that once to me already. I found the barely small sliver of health or of green bar to get out of that.
That wild strike found nothing but empty air that time.
Man, that's what you call swinging for the fences and missing. Oh, wait, nice reversal.
We're looking at complete domination here.
I think we know what this is. He's too busy bragging and boasting than battling in this matchup.
He's setting it up.
All right, Brock, let's see if I can put you away with one of my finishers.
And Davidson gets all of it.
Ouch, that had to hurt.
Wow, now that. And into the cover.
One, two, three. What a tremendous victory.
Well, the impact of me using the F5, that kind of went away. Oh, and for the record, no, I didn't change one of my finishers to the F5. I actually bought the ability to perform my opponent's finisher. I actually replaced one of my ability slots. Cause I have five of them. I didn't feel like spending $80K on a sixth.
Welcome back to the show. This is my guest tonight. Let's talk about Cesaro. It seems like as a tag team, you two are not on the same page. Do you find that true?
Heck no. Cesaro and I are awesome.
I hear what you're saying, but I have bigger things to deal with. Me and him, we're fine. I'll cross that road when it really goes down. For now, though, we're stronger than ever. I've got nothing else to say about that.
There you have it. Back to you guys.
Yeah, we're completely forgetting what I absolutely said or accidentally said a few months ago about, yeah, that's ridiculous. I'm just dragging him along, blah, blah, blah. 10 months later. Me and him are fine. We're stronger than ever. But, so to continue my original thought, and that's going to be an interesting fiddle four-way, just to get this thought out of my head, I took out the Ruthless Aggression ability, which I think is, I don't think it's one you get by default, no. Ruthless Aggression, what that does is, at least at the first level, environmental objects and foreign objects, you deal 7% more damage with. I took that out and put in the Move Thief, which says you only, which at level 1 you can only use once per match. However, we did see me go for it the first time and it got reversed. So the once per match means you actually hit the move once per match. If you go for it and get reversed out of it, it does not count as your one per match. So with that, let's go and get on with SmackDown Fatal 4-Way. We need a match for green body health and a match with Brian, Orton, and Lesnar. That is not happening. So let's go and get started with SmackDown.
And here we go with this anything goes match.
Yes, because I was aiming for Orton. I don't know why Lesnar's going for Daniel Bryan, but, sure.
It'll be interesting to see if any unlikely alliances are formed here in this fatal four-way match. Acrobatic maneuvers like that require special type of skills.
Yeah, that really makes me jealous. Another incredible battle of Randy Orton's was when he squared off against Batista in a steel cage for the WWE Championship. The match against the former Evolution members took place at Extreme Rules. And believe me, it was...
We're going to pretend that that worked.
A bit about Davidson here.
A ton of talent, a ton of ability. Certainly someone to keep...
Come on, Orton.
On.
Let's go this way.
Daniel now fully in control of this matchup.
Look out, Brock! Uh-oh!
Can you keep track of what's going on?
Submission in tight. Oh, he's going to have to block out the pain if he hopes to escape this. Oh, my gosh.
Conk.
Look at that. Another merciless blow. I think it's safe to say that if they got up from that, it would be a...
Well, he just got up from it.
Batista met inside of 15.
Okay, I'm happy.
Cage. You and I called that match at the 2009 Extreme Rules pay-per-view, and there were several times we just looked at each other in awe at the brutality Orton and Batista put one another through.
The problem is now I can barely see what I'm doing.
You're right about that. Orton and Batista's match in 2009 Extreme Rules was a brutal event, and I'll tell you why. Orton and Batista started out together in the supergroup Evolution.
I'll go and go one-on-one here, Daniel Bryan. We tend to put on some good matches.
Whether it's for the WWE Championship or because one wants to remove the other from the WWE, their matches are pure brutality. Reversal by Orton.
Standing may not be an option after that.
Well, they're standing. What are you going to do about it, Cole?
Well, it certainly wasn't due to a lack of trying, Michael.
My God, his body's been through hell, and his ribs have bore the brunt of the attack.
Oh, who on the baseball bat?
As a precaution, damaged ribs like that can make it hard to breathe.
It's pretty obvious just from looking at him that Brock Lesnar is one of the most finely conditioned athletes.
I've noticed I'm the only superstar still in the freaking green.
He looks like he's been cut from stone, Michael, doesn't he? I mean, 6'3", almost 300 pounds of pure muscle, and it's no illusion. Brock really does have power that's second to none. Oh, wait, nice reversal.
He's looking to fly.
I hope this turns out well. I don't like how slow, man, from the high rim district.
I wouldn't know what that's like. We're looking at complete domination here.
I like it. Let's get this thing done inside the ring.
Jerry, you mentioned when Randy Orton and Batista met inside a 15-foot-high steel cage. You and I called that match at the 2009 Extreme Rules pay-per-view, and there were several times we just looked at each other in awe at the brutality Orton and Batista.
Will it be enough for the win?
No.
Nice escape by Lesnar.
And it's moves like that that made Lesnar the one in 21-1.
He's delivering an old-fashioned kicking right here.
Oh, once you get out of the ring, anything can happen. You've got exposed steel, concrete, barricades, and all of it can be used to cause massive damage.
I'll say, Daniel Bryan going to beat me back to his feet.
Man, oh man, did he take a wild swing with that one.
You're right. That was wild indeed. Good thing we're over here. Oh, a serious knockout blow.
Donk.
A brutal clothesline catches in the perfect spot. Ouch.
Ah, oh, man. That'll leave your neck hurting for a while.
Back in the ring now.
Yeah, let's just see how long they can keep it in the ring. Man, he's still down after that move. I almost wonder if his bell got seriously rung there.
Here we go.
Finding a groove here.
Look at this. Here he comes. He's not done yet. Oh, no. He's here to fight. Daniel Bryan hit that one.
Well, it didn't really help that Lesnar and Orton are underway, but you might want to finish up here, Bryan.
Oh, man. F5 connects, and that has to be it. Back into the ring now.
Yeah, this is good. This is where the action needs to be. Well, that messed him all right.
No, no, Bryan, you idiot. You idiot, Bryan, you idiot. Bryan, you are an idiot. Oh, what you're pissed off about? You're the one standing there like, I'm going to hit my finisher on you. Oh, I lost.
That'll do it. Brock Lesnar walks away with the W. Hey.
Well, I guess I'd rather be Lesnar winning than Jack Swagger.
Believe me, it can be done. Guys, I think this Nashville crowd is in awe over witnessing such an incredible performance.
And for the record, when I was trying to break up the pin before the pin happened, I was actually trying to aim for the ref. Just to knock the ref out. Still not a bad match overall, I guess. Probably the date, shortest fatal four-way match I've ever had. Or if you want to go with, or if you really want to have some fun, we can have a match like what Finn Balor participated, was going to participate in here, Extreme Rules, the Final Faveway match. Seriously, I love the fact that he literally said oops and corrected himself on that. Alright, so next time we have TLC, and we get to go one-on-one with Roman Reigns on Raw. I'm curious what they're going to have me do with Lesnar at the pay-per-view, and if the authority's going to screw me over again. On the upside, though, if they do... here's the problem, though. If I don't have the title going into January, I will likely get booked in the Royal Rumble. As much as Wayne, that would be great... or going for the title at WrestleMania isn't really in the cards for me, so we'll see how it works. So with that, I thank you guys for watching, and I will see you next time.